Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're on the Sacramento River at night fishing for striped bass. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. A majority of the 445 miles of the Sacramento River is fishable for striped bass in spring, but knowing when and where to target them is key to experiencing this tremendous fishery. Today we're with guide Raith Heryford, who's fishing with Todd Storm, Jason Hambly, and Pat Haas. At sunrise, Spro ripbaits are tearing them up, but we're about done fishing as we've already had a fantastic early morning of nighttime striper fishing.
Yeah, we got up at 1 in the morning. We're down here in the Sacramento River out of Teasdale Boat Ramp. We got a full moon. The water conditions are perfect for the Teasdale area. So you got to go, if your water's high, you go high. If it's low, you go low. And Teasdale's one of our lower ramps that we fish. And so what we're doing is chasing the full moon. It's been hot in the afternoon. It's been getting up in 80 degrees, water temperature over 60. So these fish are on the bite in the early morning hours right now. So when I say early morning, I mean 1 in the morning. It's early. They start coming on 1-2 in the morning, the water will start cooling down, changing. These fish will start biting, and we've been on a pretty good pattern, catching fish up to 40 pounds this week. And we're gonna get down here, we're gonna catch some nice fish today. The water's dropping, so we might have to move down a little bit, but we already got bit, it won't be long, and we'll have fish on.
How about top water?
Not yet. Morning coming. Okay, reel them up, let's go.
Yeah, we made a few casts, and they just weren't here. I'll know this time of day, if you're not getting bit right off, then you're gonna have to make a move, and we need to make a move. It's just one little tap is not gonna, it's not really gonna do it for us. So we're gonna make a move, we're gonna head on down and find some fish.
Hey, these fish are on the bank, Raith, or are they kind of out a little bit?
Yeah, right here they're on the bank, Todd, but yeah. As soon as we come in, we're gonna come in the shallow flat, which I like fishing the flats more so than the bank. There's only so many fish can lay up against one bank, but when you have a shallow flat, the fish will be spread out all over it. That's where you get your big schools of fish. People, you make the mistake, they come out here and they think, well, I'm gonna fish the sides, and they don't realize that the flats are what's holding all your fish that are feeding. You get on a shallow flat, you're gonna get a lot more fish. And so right here, yes, we're gonna be right up against the side, and then it's gonna drop into this shallow flat, and then they're gonna be all the way back to the boat. So be ready.
Bigger keeper first fish in the morning. Nice keeper, about 20 inches.
Got double
fish coming up. Not the biggest, but still a bite. We came down here and I told Justin, man, we should get at least 20 fish off this flat. And so we just had a double. Not the biggest fish right now, but they'll get bigger. We're looking for a 40 pounder. We'll see if it happens. You always look for that, but we'll take numbers also, so.
Got a big one.
Oh, my God. Yeah, come on.
Just got a big one.
I'm down here with Raith looking for my first striper. Have never caught one, so this will be an experience.
Little one.
Little guy. Just started.
First striper.
Congratulations. Caught bait. He caught bait. Nah, that's all right. He'll get a bigger one.
Schooly striper.
Got lots of those. We've got a ton of fish. Most of them are that size, small schoolies, but we have a ton of fish this year, so it's been great. The minnow guys, everybody's been able to have a ball this year, catch fish. The guys are off the bank catching them. I mean, everybody's catching them. It's the best run we've had in just about 3 years. It's a great run this year, though. Smaller fish, due to no water, they just weren't able to grow, but now we have water. We'll have, next year, year after, we'll have good fish again, but great fish right there.
Welcome back to the Sacramento River. I'm Justin Wolf. We're nighttime striper fishing with Raith Heryford, and so far, so good.
Fish on right here. Good job.
The black rubber worm is an old standby for nighttime fishing, but Todd Storm has hooked another one on a swim bait.
Got a little swim bait there. Got to change that one out. Just tore it up.
Swim bait's on fire, man. That yesterday morning was really good, too. Normally we catch all of our fish on the Texas rig black plastic worm. But lately the smolts, there's been a lot of smolt in the river, and the swim bait's been really good. They've been catching a lot of fish on the swim bait. But the black worm's what I like to go to at night. But Todd's up there with the swim bait doing really well, and we did really well yesterday morning also with swim bait. So either back it up with swim bait, plastic worm, pretty much anything, you know, you can get in front of them. That wobble's got a little bit of vibration, you should get bit, but those are our two go-to right now. So let's go get another fish. There he is, fish on. Yeah, baby. Good job. Coming at you. Beaver.
Yep, nice. Another one. Striper fishing's a ton of fun. I like it.
You know, we were just sitting here floating down the river, and we have a full moon, and I mean, you can basically see everything. The water has dropped enough where you can see a bank, and you can see, you know, where you're casting and that. Just makes an absolutely perfect situation for fishing. You know, we turned all of our lights off. We don't even need lights tonight, and the fishermen are really good, so you don't even have to help them or anything, but it's a perfect situation tonight with the full moon, the light, the weather, light jacket, sweatshirt, perfect weather. I don't want to be out here in the middle of the heat. You know, we're almost middle of May now, so, or April, excuse me. And it's just an absolutely perfect situation tonight. It's just nice to be out here and spend our early morning hours. About 8 o'clock in the morning, we'll be over it, be ready to go home. We're all going to catch plenty of fish, but it's a, what a way to spend an early morning, a late evening. So I point the nose downriver when I can't find fish, and that way the boat goes twice as fast. Just point the nose down, bump your trolling motor a little here and there. If you got good fishermen, you can do it. If you don't, you can forget it. You're gonna be fighting it either way. But if you just go down, you slightly throw downstream, because now you're going faster than the current. Now if your nose is pointed upstream, you throw slightly upstream, because you're going slower than the current and your lure will fall. So now we're going faster than the current. We're throwing slightly downstream and it's hooking in like so. And that's how you get your bites, is on the swing. But anyway, so you point your nose downstream, you bump your trolling motor, you cover the walls 3, 4, 5 times faster, and then you'll find out if there's any fish. You turn it around, slow down, really thoroughly work it. But this way, you know, with good fishermen, you can just go down, blow down these walls. Once you find them, spin it around and catch 2 and 3 at a time.
Better quality fish here. Thank you. pounder. Swimbait. Good eater right there. Like you hear, you know, it's pretty dark out. The water's a little muddy, but a little perk here goes a long ways out here. Just put on the sides of swimbait, rub it around. Get a good scent trail. Hopefully get those bigger bites tonight. Wow. Got another good one here. Oh yeah, head shaker. He just went right out in the deep water. Oh yeah. Quality striper, right in the corner of the mouth right there. Look at that. Swimbait, it's Procure. Yeah.
Hey, what's Procure you use, Todd?
I'm using the Threadfin Shad Super Gel.
I would like to try some of what Todd's using. It's kicking our butt. Where's that at, buddy? If it works on my worm, then we're in business. I mean, when you can just put it in your pocket and you have that much confidence in it, look, everybody's going for it.
It's still hours before sunrise on the Sacramento River, where the cooler water and full moon conditions have the stripers on the bite. We're using black plastic worms and swim baits, but regardless, the key is having them rigged properly.
So we switched over to swim baits. I started getting a lot more bites on swim baits over the worm. But you can glue these and put these bait buttons on the hook here. You just slide it down. And what that'll do is, I like to do two. And what happens is when you get these smaller fish, they tend to pull your bait down. So this really kind of locks that bait in there, just like that.
Perfect.
Holds that right in there.
Thank you.
What's going on is we have a full moon, and it's late April, but the water temperature is reached 65 and a half, and we're here, you know, it's 4 in the morning. We're out here in the coolest time. That's how we get our bites. But what's going on is once it gets in the 60s and you get the full moon, they'll spawn. It just, that's the way it is. I don't know why they do it, what's the reason behind it is, but we got 65, 8, and the full moon, late April. And what we had a big, big school of fish in the Feather River, and they moved out. And I knew where they did, and they came over here on the Sack and bunched up. And so we moved on this side of the river, but we're trying to get them before they spawn. And what they'll do, they'll spawn late in the evening, and then they'll eat early morning. And sometimes you'll come out, you'll see if the water's real hot, they'll keep spawning throughout the morning. But most of the time, late evening, spawn, and then early morning they feed. So guys will come out fishing after work and that, and they'll really struggle, have a hard time catching these fish because they're spawning, and they're not eating. And so we come out, that's when I switch to nights and come out early morning and get my fish to bite. So what they're doing right now is they're spawning in the evenings, feeding in the mornings, and we're trying to get on these fish before they take off. This time of year, this school for this year right now is gonna be the biggest school we have. I would bet on it, you know, that there's more fish right now in the system than there'll be in the rest of the season. But you gotta get on them because the big fish have moved in. We're trying to catch these big fish. We'll let them go in that, but we're after, you know, 60, 70 pound fish. Hopefully, you know, 40, 50, we see those every year. So we're gonna spend our time this week, particularly, we're gonna go extra hard because we know the big fish are here. And once they spawn, they take off. They go all different directions. They go up, they go down. Todd's on a fish.
Swimbait fish.
About a 7-pound fish right there. Beautiful fish. Probably 26 inches. Nice fat, really healthy. Look how fat he is. Just grab your leader line, pull him up and over. Okay. It's easier, just real, there you go. That's how we do it. You don't hurt the fish, you do that. You don't have to have a net, you don't get everything. And just hold your leader line up. There you go, now bottom lip. Grab the bottom lip and you won't tear your swim bait up. Grab it real tight at the bottom lip. Good, just like that. See, he's milking all over the place. He's big, fresh, nice fresh fish. I'm still sticking to my worm, but he got a nice swim bait fish. Beautiful fish. We're gonna good eat, one. We'll eat that one. That's a good all one. Right. Throw him in there. I had a worm. You got it. We're getting a bad batch of worms. And you know, it's really important that your tail swims. It has to vibrate and swim. They've got a big paddle tail on theirs, and I've just got this ribbon tail. But if my tail's not swimming, I'm not going to get bit. Yeah. I mean, it has to. That's all the vibration I have. I need something. And what I started checking my worm tail, and it wasn't really swimming. So we'll get that working. And he'll throw that, and we'll keep catching fish.
Welcome back to the Sacramento River, where the smolt-imitating swimbait is catching the most fish. The smolt are migrating downstream, and the stripers understand where and how to target them.
If you're trolling downstream, you're going to get snagged, lose all your stuff, but that's where you get your bites. They like it better, your bait coming down, straight down on them, because the minnows are just firing down river this time of year, so right. You get on the side with the heavier current, like that's this walk wall side, that's why we picked this side. So next turn around, we'll jump sides of the river and go down the other side. But they definitely come down the side where the current's on, so.
Nice.
Yeah. Procure eel gel. So it's the new stuff they come out with, so, you know, we're using the worm, and I'm using the worm, everybody else switched out on me. They think that the swim bait's gonna get all the fish, but I'm gonna prove them wrong here in a second. So anyways, we're gonna put a little eel gel on. We've used the eel, that new eel, because the worm looks like an eel. These fish are up here, the eel are spawning and having, doing their thing up here too. You got all the babies and all the bigger ones also. They love to eat the eel. They're down in the sand and the mud and that. They come out. Sometimes stripers will be in that sand picking them out of there. But yeah, you throw that out there, swim it by, and something they don't normally let go by when they're hungry. So yeah, so we got the eel gel and the worm combination going on.
Oh, nice fish.
Okay, we just floated for about an hour and a half straight. And nothing. We got a fish right here, double.
Came off.
Just came off. We just got double. We know they're spawning, so we floated for an hour and a half straight, nothing. But I know these fish are all in one pile, and I had a good idea where they were, and I'm pretty sure we just found them. So here in a little bit, we should see a lot more action real quick. So just had a double. Double now? Double on?
Came off.
Double right, right. There we go. There we
got him.
Swimbait,
Todd?
Yep.
Dude, it don't matter, Todd. Uh-oh, that might be a good one. He's heading out.
Come on back. We're going under the boat, Todd. Under the boat. Come around. Skinny fish.
There we go.
Part spawned out, triple. Turn your hips towards it. There you go. Come on, Pat, right over here. Go right here, Pat, right here.
Nice fish in here.
Give yourself a line, Todd. You're gonna break your rod, bro. Woo, big fish.
This one's a good one.
We got line ripper. He got the hen.
This one's a good one.
You hear me talking about the shoe?
Thank you. what you want to do on these big, big fish. It's all the way down its throat, so we're gonna kind of swing it out, and you walk it around, and then his mouth will kind of open up. And there it is.
Ooh, yeah.
That's right.
That's a good one.
Hey, good job.
Thank you.
Hey, first night out striper fishing, he gets him a nice fish. We got the swim baits way down its throat. It's a big fish. Oh, it's not in the gill, so we gotta pop it out like that. That's it. That's it. Now we gotta let her go. Give her a kiss. He faked it. He faked it. Yeah.
That's okay. Nice. Good job. Good job.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
A lot of fun.
Awesome. Yep. That's what we came for. Good job. Nice, close to 20-pound fish right there because it was so fat. It wasn't, you know, it was about 34 inches long. Nice, fat, healthy, good fighting fish. He was strong. Being that strong, that fish is going to take a few more, probably at least a week before her eggs will get.
Yeah.
But she was still strong, fought a lot. When they almost are ready, they don't fight that much. So, good job, man.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.